Welcome back, students. So we were learning about the neural network. I'm going to continue from the last class we left behind. So what are the input and the output for a neural network is? As we are classifying the data, so your data must contain the classification attribute. So what are the classification attribute? The decision, like yes or no, 0 or 1, okay, and then approved or not approved, loan sanctioned or not sanctioned. So all these things are the decision. What decision we are going to convey at the end of the classification? So your attribute should be present in your classification data. Then we will divide the data set into two categories. As we are dealing with the classification, so your data should be divided into two parts. The first part is training data and second is testing data. Why we need training data? Training data is used to build a model. From the data, whatever the data you are having, the training set is used to build the data. This is the seen data. We know what are the attribute and what is the decision class. And why we use the testing data? Testing data is used to test the model. Right, so there are two parts: the training data used to build the model, testing data test the builded model. Okay, and both are divided into some ratio decided by the researcher. Okay, so your data should be normalized. This is the foremost condition before going to apply the classification algorithm. Your data should be error free. All your attributes should be in same range. Either it can be 0, 1 or minus 1 or 1. As per your requirement, normalize all the attributes into the same range. For example, if there are two different features in the data set, the first feature is age and the second feature is salary. So the range of age will be from 10 to or 0 to 80. Fine. 0 means the just born child, and 80 means the oldest child, right? Or 100, let's assume 100. 100 is the maximum age range. But if we talk about the salary can be from 1000 to 10 lakh. So there is a variation between these two attributes. So we have to normalize one of them to one another in order to get the similar type of contribution of both the features. So there are two basic techniques. The one is max min normalization and second is decimal scaling normalization. There are other techniques also that can be used for the normalization. We are not going into the detail of these normalization techniques because we are just focusing on the neural network itself. So what a neuron is in neural network? This is the basic structure of a neuron. First, there is some input layer which is represented by here as X, and the edge which connect the input layer to some other layer or the hidden layer which is having some weights. As we have discussed in the last class, the weights are represented by W. Then we will do some weighted sum over here. Then there is a function called activation function, and then after that activation function the output will be generated. The n dimensional input vector X is mapped into variable Y by means of the scalar product and a non-linear function mapping. So what are these activation function and what is bias, we will see in the next slides or in the next class. Network training. The ultimate objective of training is obtain a set of weights. Why we are doing training? In order to learn the actual weights so that we can build the model, right? So this is a basic phenomena of neural network. If we know the weights, there is no need for the training. What are the steps? The first step is initialize weights with random values. As we don't know the actual value of the weight, so just initialize with some random values. The second one is feed the input tuples into the network one by one. we are not going to throw all the weights, all the values, all the input values at once. Just feed one by one. For each unit, compute the net input to the unit as a linear combination of all the input to the unit. So there is something called the linear combination of all the inputs. After applying the weights and the input values, we will see how the linear combination will work. Now we are going to use some activation function. There are different type of activation function that we will see in the next class. What are these activation function is? Now compute the error. If there is some error, then you have to go back again and then train the model with different weight values. Compute the error and then update the weights and the bias. Neural network learning. The inputs are fed simultaneously into the input layer. The weighted output of these units are fed into hidden layer. So there is three important layer into the neural network. The first one is the input layer, which take the inputs, and the second one is the output layer, which produces the output. And in between the input layer and output layer, there is one more layer, or the a group of layers is known as the hidden layer. So whatever the layers are between the input and output are known as the hidden layer. The weighted output of the last hidden layer are input to units making up the output layer. So whatever the input to some layer will be output to the next.